Hi everyone, my name is Michele. In the previous video, I imported two skirt images on Zplane under Draw menu. In this video, I'm going to form a belt using frame mesh and curve strap snap. Let's get started. Shift F to turn on polyframe. Control right click, move right to zoom in. Isolate a polyloop as base for the belt. Press Command or Control Shift to use select lasso brush with lasso stroke. Hover over the vertical edge of a polygon. If it says edge, Control or Command Shift, tap on it. This will hide a strip of polyloop that goes all the way around the waist. Actually, there are two types of edges you can tap on. Left-right edge hides a horizontal strip. Top-bottom edge hides a vertical strip. So watch out for the type of strip you want to hide. In this case, a left-right edge. So I have hidden a polyloop to use as a base for the belt. Let me Control W to regroup these into another color. Then Control Shift tap on the poly to invert the visibility. If I tap on edge instead, another strip is hidden. Tapping on poly or point will invert the visibility. Let's check if the poly loop goes all the way around the waist. This will be the base to create a frame for the belt. Go under stroke menu, dock it. Under curve functions, there are three options: border, polygroups, and crease edges. Polygroup option is for creating a frame between two intersecting polygroups. In my case, there are no intersecting polygons, so when I click on frame mesh, nothing happens. But when I turn on border, turn off polygroups, and click frame mesh, curve functions will frame all borders with a curve line. Let me Control Z to undo frame mesh and unhide all polygons. Control Shift tap background. Let's try out polygroups. Border off, polygroups on. Click on frame mesh. Curve functions will form a curve at the intersection of two polygroup colors. Let me undo frame mesh and isolate this polyloop. Control Z and Control Shift tap polygroup. Border on, polygroups off, and frame mesh. Now that I have two curves available, I can pick one to put a belt on. Let's test it out. BC9, brush, curve, strap snap. Click on a curve line with the selected brush. And just like that, we can have a fitting belt on the waist. Should I keep the higher or lower belt? I think I'll use the lower curve line. Let's use Z Modeler brush to delete the top curve line. BZM, hover over the top curve line. When the word delete appears, press spacebar to see the actions available. Do I want bevel or delete? Delete. Do I want all curves or just a curve? Just a curve. Then click on the curve I want to delete, and that's it. Let's go back to brush, curve, strap snap. Click on the curve line and check the placement. What about the width and thickness of the belt? Let's change the brush size under draw menu. Draw size affects the width. Z intensity affects the thickness. I can also use spacebar as a shortcut to change the draw size and Z intensity. Let's try draw size 200, then click on the curve line. Let me quickly adjust it to a desired thickness and width. Sometimes I accidentally moved it when I click on it. So I just need to undo and re-click on the curve line. If it's embedded into the waist, try to thicken the belt using Z intensity. There's another way to raise it above the waist. In the next tutorial, I will use Curve tab under Brush menu to do this. To lift the belt above the curve line so that it's not sunken. If you find this video helpful, do subscribe and see you in the next video.